वेलकम टू समग्र शिक्षा अभियान सिद्दीपेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट तेलंगाना। माय नेम इज के सत्य प्रमोद। आई एम वर्किंग एज अ पीजीटी मैथमेटिक्स इन दौलताबाद मंडल सिद्दीपेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ए न्यू टॉपिक। सो बिफोर अनाउंसिंग द टॉपिक लेट अस गिव मी ए हिंट टू द व्यूअर्स सो दैट दे कैन गेस द टॉपिक। सो लेट अस गेट इन टू द टॉपिक। Now, to understand the name of the topic or to guess the topic, name of the topic, let us observe the graph which is shown in the picture. Now, there is a graph, bar graph. All of you know about this bar graph. Now, see, there are four categories mentioned here: category 1, category 2, category 3, and category 4. So, these four categories which are appearing on the screen, if you observe carefully, out of these four, one of the category is completely different from other three. So what is that category? That we have to observe. Now if you observe very closely, category 1 having four bars, with each bar like this blue to the red, red to the green, and green to the purple. If you observe very carefully, what do you observe is the height of each and every bar is increased by 1 unit. Now, if you come to the category 2, and this time if you observe the four bars, in the category 2, height of each and every time when the bar moving from blue to red and red to green and green to purple, every time what is happening here, children? Here it is increasing by 2 units every time. So here 2 units gap, and here also 2 units gap, here also 2 units gap. It is becoming 2 to 4, 4 to 6, and 6 to 8. Now coming to the category 3. So this time, now this is the 3. It is representing height as 3 and 3, and next it is representing height as 7, and it is representing height as 11, and it is representing height as 15. Means each and every time it is increasing by 4 units. So this is 1 unit, this is completely 2 units, and this is another 1 unit. Means completely 4 units. And coming to the category 4, blue to red, one unit is increased. Red to green, 2 units increased, and green to purple, again 2 units increased. Means what is happening here in category 4? In category 4, the height of the bar is increased, but not uniformly, not identically. So out of category 1, category 2, category 3, and category 4, which is a different category of bars, which part of the graph is different or odd one is nothing but category 4. So what I want to tell you means, here the things which are increased in a uniform matter in our subject, of course numbers, the numbers which are increasing in a uniform manner, we are discussing about those kind of numbers. So what are those numbers are called, and what is the purpose of learning those numbers, how they are helpful in day-to-day life. What is the introduction of those kind of numbers? Let us see the introduction. What is the name? What is the purpose of learning? Who invented or who discovered that one? What is the name of the topic? Let us move into that one. Maybe name can be different. Okay? Name can be different from your guess to my guess, but meaning will be the same. Now, the graph which is shown in the earlier side, let us see the same data in the numerical form. Now the first series are category 1 having the numbers as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which are called counting numbers, and 2 which are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and which are obviously, you know all of you, as even numbers. And third category 3, 7, 11, 15, and 19, each number is increasing by 4. And uniformly it is increasing, every time increased by 4. 3 will become 7 by increasing 4 or adding 4. 7 will become 11 by adding again 4. 11 to 15 again by 4. And 15 to 19, it will convert. 15 will become 19 by adding 4. So the first three are same and identical in one manner, but the fourth one is different comparing to the first three. So let us move to the topic. The thing which we observe is, we observe that the series of numbers with same common difference, obviously we have seen that increase is happening in a uniform manner. So the same thing is written in another form of sentence. We observe that series of numbers with same common difference, and these type of series of numbers are called in progression. The numbers are in what? Progression. Progression is nothing but, all of you know that, something which is increasing. In general, in English, in progression word is used for means you are showing some growth. Okay. Now coming to the our name of the chapter is progression. So progression is nothing but these progressions follow the rules throughout the series. So we have seen that examples already. Based on the rules, there are two types of progression. So it is not like that we have only one type of progression. We have two types of progression. What are those two types of progression? The first one is arithmetic progression and the second one is geometric progression. So in our chapter name is progression, we have two topics majorly. One is arithmetic progression and second one is geometric progression. So let us move to the introduction to the topic number one, which is nothing but arithmetic progression. So let us take an example which is already discussed. 3, 7, 11, 15, 19, which is a series which is in the form of progression, especially in the form of arithmetic progression. Why it is in arithmetic progression is nothing but by adding a fixed quantity 4 to each and every number to get the next number or succeeding number. For preceding number, we are adding 4 as a constant number and which is maintaining as a common difference throughout the series. So in this example, this is an example for an AP. In this example, first term is 3. Generally, in this chapter, we are going to treat the first term as small a. So small a is equal to 3 and common difference d easily can be find out by subtracting the second number minus first number, which is nothing but 7 minus 3, which is equal to 4. Okay. So now I think all of you understand very well about arithmetic progression. So arithmetic progression is a series of numbers which is maintaining a particular common difference. In this particular examination, we are starting with the number 3 and we are maintaining the common difference as 4. So can you prepare 3 more progressions like this? Yes, of course you can prepare 3 more any number of progressions like this. So you try and discuss with your friend after this video. Now let us move to the next part of the slide. So next part is, what is an AP? Actually, what is the definition of an AP? AP is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. The gender form of AP is A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D and so on. And what do you mean by A and D here? A is nothing but the first term and D is nothing but the common difference which is maintained throughout the list or throughout the series. So this will be understood more deeply in the upcoming videos. Now let us think and discuss some basic things, some questions or some points which we learn. From the points which we learn, make an arithmetic progression. AP is nothing but arithmetic progression. Make an arithmetic progression in which common difference is 10. Make an arithmetic progression in which the common difference is minus 5. Observe children, if you can do the second one, means you understood the complete video properly. Because minus 5 is nothing but you are decreasing the value. Suppose you are starting with number 10. Minus 5 difference means you have to reduce it to 10 minus 5, which is equal to 5. Means 10, 5, 0, minus 5, minus 10 and so on. Suppose you are starting with 50. So each time you have to decrease 5. So 50, 45, 40, 35, 30 and so on. Means the arithmetic progression can have a numbers with the decreasing order also. Okay. Now make an AP with the common difference as plus 4 and the first term is 0. This is completely your work. You think and discuss with your friends. Definitely you will come to the right answer after discussion. Now this is a tricky question and this will judge you. Did you really understand the video or not? is always an AP is finite or infinite? Justify your answer. Is it compulsory to be having a list of numbers finite or infinite? Is it compulsory? Is there any rule that we have only infinite number of terms in AP or only finite number of terms in AP or both? What you can say about this? This will bring what kind of discussion, proper discussion, so that you can understand the arithmetic progression thoroughly when you discuss with your friends. Thank you, children. So let us see some historic note about this particular video. Now there is a evidence is found that by 400 BCE, Babylonians knew about arithmetic progression and geometric progression, which are actually progressions. See, long ago, 400 BC, but they might not know about the terms in which we are learning, but they really know how to calculate them in easier way. Now, coming to the Indian mathematician, among the Indian mathematician, Aryabhatta was the first person who gave the formula to the sum of the squares and cubes of a natural numbers in his Aryabhattiyam book. Now, about this point, definitely we are going to concentrate in the upcoming videos. Now, you can see Aryabhatta picture on the your textbook, mathematics 10th class textbook, and obviously there is a picture is given here. So children, this is the video for today. I hope all of you understand very clearly. If any other problem, let us discuss personally, and thank you for watching video, and thank you one and all. Thank you.